Hey y'all, what's up? Sapo here. It's right before Thanksgiving, and you know what that means, turkey. So I got me 11.4 pound bird. Gonna thaw it out, we're gonna brine it, we're gonna inject it, we're gonna rub it, we're gonna fry it, and then we're gonna eat it. And I wanna give a shout out to Rus Jones of Smoky Ribs because I followed his directions. And that's how I'm gonna make this baby. So without further ado, let's start seasoning. Without further ado, let's get started. All right, inside here, this Cody ice chest, we have a bird. Let's take a look at it. It's a frozen bird, yes. Get it out. First thing you want to do, get your camera on your phone or a piece of paper if you're old school. And write down the poundage of the bird. Since I'm not old school, which I really am, but I have my phone right here, I'm gonna take a picture of the label. Okay, the reason you do that, you wanna record the pound. This is 11.38. We're gonna times that by 3.5, and that'll give you how many minutes to keep it in the hot oil. Just a little thing to do. But know how, this is thawing out right now, and that's a good thing. We're gonna put it inside some brine. We're gonna take it out of this bag. It's already soft, but it's just frozen in the middle. I'm gonna put it inside a bag with some brine. I'm gonna put it back in this ice chest and then put some ice in there. Keep it cold and let it thaw out and brine at the same time. And then once it's all the way thawed out, it'll continue to brine. Okay, and before we do that, some people want to go ahead and inject it and all that, but we have to put it inside of the frying apparatus and then fill up water to see how much oil we need. So before we take this off, I'm going to do that. Even though it has a cavity, I'm going to fill it up and get a rough estimate on how much oil to put in it. So with that being said, let me get the stainless steel pot and I'll bring it out here and we'll go ahead and do some measuring. Okay, all right, gonna take our bird, still has the wrapping on, it's okay, we just want to get a measurement. Just set it in there, lay it in there however you want. I laid it in there, and let's get this put on the correct setting right there. Start filling it up. Okay, a filling up we will do. And on the front of this, it has a line that says don't fill over this high. And I don't think we're even gonna get close to that. So what you're doing, as you can see down in there, look in there. I'm filling it up to cover the bird. And then a tiny bit more because the bird's still got ice inside of it. Right there. About right there. That should be it. And guess what? It's right at that line. Interesting. Can't argue with the pot, man. Is that right? Oh, it's below the line, just a tiny bit. Okay, now what we do, and remember the bird's in there. The bird is a lot of volume, man. So now we take the bird, lift it up, dump any water that's in it, which isn't that much, put it over there, and now we have a line that's about 5 inches less than it was with the bird in there. So I'll get a paper towel, I'll clean the side, and that's one way of doing it, marking it, or you can actually pour this into a measuring cup pitcher and add up how much it is. That's another way. So, well, right here we have 1 gallon of water that's just below boil. We're going to add 1 cup of kosher salt, high quality kosher salt. It dissolves better. 1/2 cup of sugar. I didn't have any brown sugar, so I just used sugar. 1/8 cup of peppercorns, crushed up a little bit. And some bay leaves from my plants outside. Let's drop it in. And get you something and stir it till it dissolves. You could shut off the fire right now and just let this come back to room temperature before we put the bird in it and we add some ice. We're gonna brine it for 24 hours. So next scene, we're gonna make the injection. Then by that time, hopefully this will be cool and we'll put the bird in the brine. All right, we got 1 cup approximately of lemon juice going in. It's our injector. This little bottle of crab and shrimp boil from Zatarain's going in. Onion juice, tablespoon. Going in. Garlic juice, tablespoon, going in. Louisiana hot sauce, tablespoon, going in. And for good measure, some Tony's, going in. All right, let that get to know each other, warm it up a little bit, let it cool off, and keep it ready to inject the bird after we're done brining. Okay, I've put the bird into a brining bag. Right here, it's like a gigantic, heavy-duty Ziploc baggie, more or less. But it's in there, still a little bit frozen, thawed out on the outside. I need to get a bag of ice. But here's the brine, and it's cooled off now. So we'll simply pour it in. Put everything in, the bay leaves, everything, it doesn't matter. And the pepper. Whoop. Pepper, get in there. That's good. Actually, I want to get all of it. All right. Now that's good. Okay, lay it down in there best as possible. There. And then we're gonna zip this. Something like that. Get as much air out as possible. Well, zipped it too good, folks. There. And that's the point right there. Get the air out, get it in there, and we'll put a bag of ice on this and then we'll shut this back up, okay? For 24 hours, let it brine. And you can turn it if you want. If you feel as if the other side's not getting enough, go ahead and turn it. It's not gonna hurt anything. All right? Well, here's our bird. It's been brined. It's ready to inject. Here's our injection concoction. When I made the injection concoction, I forgot to tell you that It has a stick of butter and 2 cups of chicken broth or bouillon, whatever you got. But I forgot to tell y'all. So let me stir this up. I kept it in the fridge. The butter went to the top. I had to warm it up a tiny, tiny bit. Won't hurt anything. So let's get started. I cut the tail off too. The front's okay. Just fill up your syringe according to how big your hands are, see? And just simply put it in a little bit that way, a little bit that way. Go about another inch, a little bit that way, a little bit that way. That, that. It's okay if some comes out. We're gonna dry it off afterwards. But you get the point, right? Let me do some to the legs. Same thing. Just put it wherever you want to have some flavor up in there. These legs got ligaments. It don't got to be perfect, no how. This stuff's really spicy. All right, you got the point. Let me do the rest, and then we'll dry it off, and we'll hit it up with some rub. And hopefully it's not going to rain, because I want to fry it today. Well, he is all dried off. We're going to hit it up with some Tony's right here. So let's just do that. Put it everywhere. Don't worry about it. Give him some under the arm. Back where the tail used to be, put some over there too. Just get it everywhere. Don't worry about it. Shut up! Sorry. Man, go back to sleep. Have the front door open so they can see out there. Okay, let's do the other side now. It's virtually dry, it's just a little bit damp, which is good. Let the seasoning stick. All right. Okay, now we must put it on this apparatus here. Apparatus. Go grab these legs right here. Pick it up. Put this apparatus here and just lay it through like that. And once you get that like that, you can add a little bit more on these legs in places you didn't get some before, and even inside for good measure. Why not? It's all good, folks. All right, get the oil ready and we'll go for it. Let me show you what we got here. There you go, the bird. Okay, we've got our oil up to 350 degrees, I believe. Let me make sure again. And once we hit that, we're going to kill the propane. Yeah, close enough. First thing we're going to do, we're going to kill the propane so we won't have a fire if it happens to go over. The next thing we're going to do, we're going to put on these protective gloves. And all that good stuff. Just for safety. And we're going to get this hook right here. We're going to lift the bird up and slowly put him in. And when I say slowly, I mean slowly. You just go up and down like that. Up and down, in a little, out a little, in a little, out a little, in a little, out. Keep putting it up and down like that, okay? It looks like I might have to add a little more oil. It's in now. Okay, we can take these off now. We're going for 35 minutes. Take those off. Get our fire going again. Check our temp. Yeah, I gotta add about that much more. Let me go get it. Hold on. We'll get this cranking, by the way. Just a little bit more. His butt's not under the oil. There. It'll work. Well, it's about halfway through. It's coming along very well. I'm going to give you all a sneak peek, okay? Of the color. Just look at that. Beautiful color, man. The oil's staying about 325, so I got this thing cranked up all the way, but that's a good temp, you know. It'll cook it nice. It's not gonna burn it. It's gonna cook all the way through. It's a little bird, 11 pounds, man. So we'll be back when it's done. Then we're gonna finalize this video and get to making sides. Happy Thanksgiving, wherever you are, whatever day it is, in forever. Well, the time has come. It's 35 minutes. It's time to take it off. So first thing you do, you shut off your gas. All the way, shut this off too. Off. Take your temperature gauge out. Don't need it anymore. Get all that out of the way now. Get your hook here and get a pan or something to put it on. The turkey. Just pull it up. Let the oil drain. Look at that bird, folks. That's good. Get it over yonder. I reckon you want to see the breasts. Most men do. Beautiful color right there. We'll take a look at it and we'll let it rest and we're going to eat it. Not the whole thing. Well, here she is. Almost broken half. Let's just get a piece up from right here. Nice piece. Oh yeah, look at it. Perfect. And you can see the injection right there. Nice. We'll get a piece from there and then we'll for the heck of it, we'll get a piece from right here. Try to. Yeah, there we go. I like the thighs. Oh, come here, boy. Oh, boy, look at that. Is that amazing or what? And then this piece right here. Oh, yeah. Come to Papa right now. Oh, man. Rus Jones, you the man. Oh, man. Okay. Taste test time on the camera. Wow. All right. The time is here. Again, to test it. Try this piece of breast meat. Mmm. That's unbelievably good. That's the best deep fried turkey I've ever had. Oh man. That Louisiana hot sauce and that seafood boil together with all that concoction is off the chart. This is nice. It's hot, but it's not habanero hot. It's like a crawfish boil. Just a perfect heat. That's amazing, man. Wow. Y'all gotta try this. That's just crazy. I mean, go to Smoky Ribs. Smoky with no E after the K and before the Y. With the word ribs. And then once you get there, type in turkey. And you'll see a bunch of, he has all kinds of videos. But look for the one where he did two turkeys together. And you'll see the concoction. And thanks again, Smoky Ribs. Appreciate it. This made my 2020 a lot better now. Oh, man. All right, y'all. Thanks for watching. Subscribe, comment, like, all of the above. Please share on all social medias. Trying to get this channel going a little bit more. Trying to make a little bit better videos. Hope you enjoy them, you know. But until next time, God bless you and adios, amigos.